Welcome to the Fit Small Business QuickBooks Online Training Course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to run a balance sheet report in QuickBooks Online. To follow along with me, log into your QuickBooks Online account now or click the link below for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. You can also click this link to access our full QuickBooks Online course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. The balance sheet includes the assets, liabilities, and owner's equity for your business. Assets are those items owned by the company. For example, computers, business equipment, and inventory are assets. Liabilities are what you owe to others. For example, a loan on a vehicle that you use for business or a business line of credit that you have with your bank are liabilities. Owner's equity reflects the net amount of money that the owner or other investors have invested in the business, as well as money retained from profits, also known as retained earnings. The numbers on the balance sheet provide a snapshot of the financial position of the business at the exact point in time that the balance sheet was prepared. The balance sheet is as of a specific date, for example, December 31st, 2016, whereas the profit and loss statement, which we covered in the previous lesson, is for a period of time, for example, January 1st through December 31st, 2016. This is one of the primary differences between these two financial statements. To help demonstrate the components of the balance sheet, we will use a fictitious company, Paul's Plumbing. As indicated here, I have identified four sections of the balance sheet for Paul's Plumbing. Section 1 shows total assets. In this section, Paul has several assets listed: bank accounts, inventory, and undeposited funds. Bank accounts. The amounts shown here are what the QuickBooks register reflects as the bank account balance as of September 29, 2016. In the How to Reconcile Your Bank Accounts lesson, we walk through step by step how to match up your QuickBooks register with your bank statement. Next, we've got inventory. This is the value of Paul's inventory on hand as of September 29, 2016. To ensure accuracy, an inventory count should be done on an annual basis, and adjustments should be made in QuickBooks to reflect any differences between inventory that you have on the shelf compared to what is in QuickBooks. Last but not least is undeposited funds. The amount that is sitting in this account is typically credit card sales that have not been deposited to your bank account. In the How to Manage Credit Card Sales lesson, we walk through step by step how to use the undeposited funds account. Section 2, Total Liabilities. In this section, Paul has listed his outstanding credit card balances. The amounts shown here are what the QuickBooks register reflects as the credit card balance as of September 29, 2016. In the How to Reconcile Your Credit Card Accounts lesson, we walk you through step by step how to match up your QuickBooks register with your credit card statement. Section 3 is total equity. In this section, Paul has opening balance equity and net income listed. Opening balance equity. This is a default account created by QuickBooks. This account should be used to code beginning balances to when setting up QuickBooks for the first time. For example, when you set up a bank account in QuickBooks, you have to enter the opening balance of that account into QuickBooks so that you will be able to reconcile the account later on. The amount that you enter as an opening balance is coded to the opening balance equity account behind the scenes. This account should eventually be closed out to retained earnings once you have finished setting up QuickBooks. Net income. This figure comes directly from the bottom line of your profit and loss statement. At the end of the year, QuickBooks will automatically transfer this amount to the retained earnings account. Retained earnings is an accumulation of the net profit or loss in your business since you opened your doors. Section 4, Total Liabilities and Equity. This is the total of sections 2 and 3. From an accounting perspective, total liabilities and equity will always equal assets. This holds true for Paul's balance sheet report. Total assets here, as we can see in section 1, is $17,976.72, and the total amount of liabilities plus equity equals $17,976.72 here in item number 4. Let's go ahead and go into QuickBooks and walk through the steps of how to run a balance sheet report in QuickBooks Online. From the left-hand menu bar, go ahead and click on Reports. Make sure that you are on the Recommended Reports tab here, and then you will see Balance Sheet to the right of Profit and Loss. So go ahead and click on that Balance Sheet link. Here we've got several options. The first option that we have is to print the report. So you can print the report, you can also email the report. So if there's someone that you would like to review the report, like your accountant or tax professional, you can email it to them directly from QuickBooks. You're also able to export the report. If you click the drop-down arrow to the right of export, you can export the report to Excel. You can also customize the report. We click on the customize option here. There are several categories that are listed here that will allow us to categorize the general characteristics of the report, such as the accounting method, the rows and columns. We can customize the list information, the format of the numbers, and also the header and footer information. The collapse button here is used if you use subaccounts. This button allows you to hide that level of detail if you want to just show a summarized version of the report. You're also able to save any customizations that you make the report so that you can use them for future reports. Down below that is where you want to select your transaction date. You can select from the preset transactions that QuickBooks has here, or you can actually select the specific period of time that you'd like to run the report for. And then once you make your selections for the date, you want to go ahead and click this Run Report button so that it takes in all the changes. And here is our balance sheet report for that time period for Paul's Plumbing. You should now have a pretty good understanding of what the balance sheet report is, why it's important, and how to run a balance sheet report in QuickBooks Online. Here are a few processes that I recommend you put into place immediately. First, reconcile all bank and credit card accounts on a monthly basis. Second, you want to implement regular inventory counts to ensure QuickBooks matches actual inventory that you have on the shelf. Third, review your balance sheet report on a monthly basis, if not more often. Fourth, be sure any discrepancies between your balance sheet and bank accounts or credit card accounts are handled in a timely manner. Fifth, be sure that all outstanding money that you owe to others has been accounted for. For example, any line of credit, any bank loans, any personal loans, etc. And finally, share your balance sheet with your accountant or tax professional for further guidance. That wraps up the lesson on how to run a balance sheet report in QuickBooks Online. To access our full QuickBooks Online course or any of the other lessons in this series, click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. If you have feedback about this course or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.